So yeah, there's no plan. It's just an idea, like usual. There's never a plan. Hi, I'm Shane, and welcome to Lohre Farm. So today, Van and I are gonna work on these greenhouse doors. We're coming along pretty good since we put these greenhouses up, and man, I am so excited. We've already got tons of stuff growing in there. It's growing like wildfire, so this is gonna be excellent. I'm really excited for this year. We got so much planned for these. I'm super excited. We're gonna do tomatoes like I've never done them before in my life. I'm really excited to show you guys that. That'll be coming up soon. But we're gonna get some doors put on these. Hey, Sadie, you excited?
This is here. This is here to join the pack.
Come on, tear that plastic off like a man. No, I meant swear at it. Whoa. Hey, nice spot. Bet that's nice and shady down there, isn't it? Yeah, you pick a good spot, didn't you? Somebody was smart enough to save the old door, which is pretty cool, off of the old greenhouse. And I'd like to take credit for it, but it was probably more out of laziness than anything. Just didn't have time to tear it apart. So we're gonna do that. So we're half done and we just got going. So that's pretty exciting. Other than that, we're gonna steal the dimensions off of that to make the door for the other greenhouse and make things a lot easier on ourselves. Van's just about got the plastic all tore off of the old one so that we can take some measurements off the framing. We'll be set. Hi, Tula. You look relaxed. Well, we got one door put on and we got to get it wrapped. Actually, what the plan is, I'm gonna have to back up here so you can see it a little bit better. So we basically made it so there's a bottom two-thirds and then a top third. And what my plan is that the bottom two-thirds is gonna be wrapped in the plastic, and then the top third is gonna be chicken wire. And the chicken wire, got it set up over here. We got it cut it up. The top's gonna be the chicken wire. So basically what that'll do is that'll make it so that there can be a pass through for bees and other pollinators to be able to come in to the greenhouse. And then I think I'm gonna talk with Sarah, and maybe what we'll do on the top is do like a little curtain of some sorts for at night, just to kind of hold the heat in the greenhouse. And then during the day we can open the curtain and let the bees come through, but still maintain the closed up greenhouse to keep the chickens and ducks and dogs and kids and neighbor kids and all the other kids out of it. So, but there's one thing I did forget. I forgot to get the dang latches, and I'm gonna have to look around. I know I got latches from the old one from last year, but I cannot remember where I put them. So, well, like I mentioned earlier, I'm pretty excited about this OHN. For these zucchini and cucumber plants and some of the pumpkins and that, I'm gonna put Oriental Herbal Nutrients on it. Oriental Herbal Nutrients is made of two parts angelica, licorice root, ginger, garlic, cinnamon, and it's basically fermented over the course of a few months and mixed together, and it can be put on as a natural pesticide. And you want to put it on in the evening as a foliar spray. One negative towards it is that if it does rain or you want to water the plants, you will have to reapply it each time. Well, we got all the zucchini and pumpkin sprayed, so check in on it tomorrow and see how it's looking. You get a little bit of fuzz on your face. I Hey, we thank you for watching. If you're enjoying this video and getting anything out of it, even the slightest bit of entertainment, please peck that like button. That really helps us out on YouTube's algorithm, pushes this video out to a lot more people so that they can see it and enjoy it as well. Thank you. Well, I came out and applied that Oriental herbal nutrients last night, and I'm checking it out here this morning. Oh, hey Deuce, how's it going? And I'm still seeing the little bugs on the leaves, but I don't think I'm seeing any more damage. So I don't know if they're still around, but they're not really eating any more of the plants or what the deal is. So I think I'm gonna just keep an eye on it today and see what ends up happening and go from there. Hey Deucey, how's it going? Yeah, things are looking good. Beets are coming up pretty quick.
Yeah, especially the ones Libby's working on.
Oh wow, look at those. How's it going, Lib?
Good.
Good. Where we planted some peas in between boxes, and I'm gonna put some fence in between so that they can grow up kind of like a trellis in between the planter boxes. That should work out pretty good. We've done that before last year, and it worked out really, really nice. Sarah's out in the garden with Libby. They're doing a little bit of just weeding this morning, just some easy stuff. It's a really nice morning out here. How's it going?
Good. Slowly getting the weeds gone.
Yeah, I think it's important just if we just clear up right around them. Then once we get some more grass cut, we'll be able to fill in everything and not deal with any of the weeds.
Get the stakes in?
Yeah, they're all in and ready to go. Okay. Peas are starting to grow, so hopefully, I'm a little worried that the potatoes are growing so fast that they're gonna block them out, but we'll see.
We need to mound them, the potatoes.
Yeah, that's true. So we can get in there later and do that. What do you think, Tula? It's hot as hell out here, isn't it? You guys don't want to come in here. It's too hot. Yep, it's too hot. Well, we got all the cages in for the peppers. Now we're just waiting on the peppers to get a little bit bigger before we transplant them over here. Sarah's working over here. We're putting in some zucchini and some summer squash. Not sure there's a difference. I don't know, is there a difference?
Nutritionally, not really.
Okay.
Otherwise, yeah.
Oh, so okay. So we're putting in green stuff and yellow stuff.
Yeah.
All right, perfect.
Yep.